Hi, I'm Ryan Kliethermes with KE2 Therm. The KE2 LDA communication device has created the ability to access the KE2 Temp family of products through web pages. This means you can now remotely monitor and adjust the controller set points, as well as receive alarm notifications via text message or email. Before we jump onto the LDA, first make sure your devices are already connected to the LDA and the LDA is connected to the network. Next, you should connect the LDA using an Ethernet cable attached to the LAN port or through wireless. Now you're ready to start. From your connected device, launch a web browser and navigate to the LDA's main page. This is accomplished by either entering the direct IP address of the controller, https://192.168.50.1, or https://KE2LDA, and then the last six digits of the LDA's MAC address. Then you'll be on the KE2 LDA dashboard. There are separate videos looking at the dashboard and management console if you need more information. But for this video, we'll focus on the KE2 Temp controller. Once we find the KE2 Temp in the list, select it to display its web page. Here we are on that KE2 Temp's web page. At the top, we see the user-defined description of the controller, followed by the KE2 Therm controller type, and finally a button for the type of view. Simple view is used primarily for end users and only displays basic information. By selecting Show Advanced View, you can see the basic information as well as current system states. So system mode, which here is refrigerate, then the current room temperature, the compressor relay, and alarm status. Below this, we have manual system control, which forces the controller to the next system mode. They are defrost, refrigerate, and off. Then we get to the set point section where you can make adjustments. Clicking the question mark reveals the set point details. Here for the room temperature, we see the limits, a minimum and max temperature. And below that in gray, we see the current system settings. We can scan across the row and see air temp differential. Then compressor starts per hour, defrost time, defrost per day, high temp alarm offset, high and low temp alarm delay, low temp alarm offset, Modbus address, temperature units. This can all be managed from the front of the controller, but using the web page allows the set points to be seen together. The last section of the web page is the device info. So the firmware version, Modbus address, timeout counter, which indicates the quality of connection, the device name, this is where you can give the controller a name that's meaningful to you, the firmware ID, which for KE2 Temps is always 20643, and then the KE2 Therm controller designation. One last thing I want to mention is that the settings for the alarm notifications for the KE2 Temp is done through the KE2 LDA's management console. The web pages for other serial controllers are formatted the same. Here's the KE2 Temp Plus Valve, KE2 Low Temp, and the KE2 Adaptive Control web pages. Check out our other videos about the KE2 Temp and KE2 VAP families of individual web pages. For more information, visit our website or contact our tech support line.